Hello and welcome to another video. In this video, we are going to make a mini potato cannon. In a potato cannon, projectile is loaded from the front and air pressure or combustion of a flammable gas is used to launch the projectile at high speed. Here I am going to use butane as fuel and a spark is used to ignite the fuel and fire the projectile. My plan is to use a glass tube for the combustion chamber so that I can see the combustion. I'll be cutting the glass tube from an old Jeldal flask. I made this 3D printed jig for cutting glass. On the bottom, we have two rollers to support the tube, and on the top, a Stanley roller glass cutter is fixed on a 3D printed part. Two stainless steel rods are used to guide it. Length of the glass tube being cut can be adjusted by moving the stopper at the end. Once everything is tightened, pressure is applied from the top and glass is rotated to score it. Glass breaks better under water, so the tube is immersed in water and broken off. Any protruding pieces are removed using a plier. Also, don't be stupid, break it away from your hand. Ends can be wet sanded to finish it. I have started with 80 grit sandpaper and finished with 200 grit sandpaper. Now we have a beautiful glass tube for the chamber, hope it won't break. Barrel is made from a pen body. Closing end of the chamber and the part joining chamber and the barrel are 3D printed in ABS. I will glue the end plug of the pen to the ABS part so that I can remove the barrel if needed. All the parts are glued with CA glue. Since the combustion is only momentarily, it won't affect the 3D printed parts or the plastic barrel. But successive firing with a short cooldown time would be a problem. As expected, I applied too much force and broke the glass. Maybe I can use end of this test tube as the chamber. Or maybe not. At last, I managed to cut a nice glass tube from the test tube for the chamber without breaking it. Borosilicate glass is preferred since it can handle thermal shock. Now I have to do some testing to see whether this will work on a small scale. I am using butane as fuel and a syringe is used to measure the amount of fuel supplied to the chamber to find the perfect fuel air ratio. My first plan was to use a valve to supply the fuel to the chamber, but I can't control the fuel volume accurately. Too little or too much fuel won't give a proper combustion. In this case, it has to be 1:15.6. So I have to find a way to precisely supply fuel to the combustion chamber. My plan is to use a cylinder filled with fuel, and by moving the piston a measured length, I can supply a precise amount of fuel. Cylinder is made from aluminium tube and the piston is from an O-ring sandwiched between two plastic rings. End caps are 3D printed and glued with epoxy. A little silicone grease inside the tube will give better seal and reduce friction. Now I am left with one more problem. After firing, the ambient air will rush into the chamber, but that's not enough for the succeeding firing. So I have to find some way to supply more air into the chamber. My idea is to make a pump from a glass syringe. I have cut the syringe barrel and the plunger to the correct size using the glass cutter. A hole is drilled on the bottom of the plunger using a diamond bit for the air to enter. Also, I have to make a one-way valve. I am using rubber valve material from 3MS to make the one-way valve. Valve material is attached to the 3D printed part and inserted into the plunger. When the plunger is pushed forward, one-way valve opens and lets the air into the pump. Most of the air will enter through the valve since the other side is a restricted flow path. And when plunger is pushed back, the valve closes and the air is pushed into the chamber. Now we need a body to hold all these components together. Body is split into different parts and printed on ABS. First, I am fixing the piezo igniter from the lighter. Handle is made from 3D printed part and two stainless steel tube. All parts are glued with CA glue. The part holding the combustion chamber is made as small as possible so that it won't block our view. I am using stainless steel needle for connecting the pump and the combustion chamber. Needle will be work hardened by extrusion, so it is annealed by heating and bent to form the connection. My first plan was to use a paper clip to make the high voltage connection from the piezo igniter, but I was having high voltage leak. So I used copper wire covered with thick tube as a conductor. These tubes are from a butterfly needle. Ends of the wires are connected to the terminals of the piezo igniter and spark gap of 5mm is kept inside the combustion chamber. A small stainless steel tube is bent to make the connection between the fuel cylinder and the combustion chamber. Connections are press fitted so that I can remove it to refill the fuel cylinder. I am filling the fuel cylinder with the butane from a lighter. As per my testing, I have to supply 2 milliliters of gas for a single shot. Now everything is ready. First, the pump is used to fill the chamber with air. Now we need projectile. Why not use potato itself? I am using a pipe to cut the potato to exact diameter. Projectile is loaded into the barrel. Finally, the piston is moved a marked length to supply the fuel. It can hold fuel for 10 shots. Now we just have to press the piezo igniter. Thanks for watching the video. Please put your thoughts and new video ideas on the comment section. I will see you on the next video. Bye.